We just got done talking about mom, that's the queen. Let's talk about dad, which is the king. Although to be honest with you, the king is more like granddad because he moves really slowly. Nice guy, but not gonna beat you in a foot race. In fact, let's have a little race. If we were to race from the bottom of the board to the top, the queen could get there all in one turn. We learned that about the queen. But the king, he's only allowed to move one square at a time. So it would take the king a long time to get to the top of the board. It would take him 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're still not there. 7 moves. The queen's gonna win a race every single time. It's not like the tortoise and the hare, where the hare goes to sleep and the tortoise wins. The queen is always gonna win. Let's remove the queen from the board, and just like all the other pieces, let's put granddad right in the middle of the chessboard. The king can move any direction just like the queen, but we already said he can only go one square at a time. So the king can go up to the square e5, or down, or left, or right, and of course diagonal. Those are 8 different directions, but only 8 different movements. Remember, when the queen was in the middle of the board, because she can move an unlimited number of squares, she had 27 different moves. The king is not really considered a fighting piece. In fact, the king has some really special value. Once you get done with the pawn levels and move on to the knight levels, you're gonna learn about why the king is the most important piece. He's actually the only piece that you can't capture. However, the king can do some capturing of his own. Let's give black a piece on the square f5. Because that piece, the rook, is one square away, the king can capture it by moving one square diagonal and landing on top of it. What about if this bishop was on the square d5? Could the king capture that one? No, it's too far away. Granddad does not go running down the street. However, the king can move sideways, and if that bishop is silly and doesn't see the danger, then the king can move and land on top of it, capturing it on the next turn. Of course, the bishop, he can move as far away as he wants to, and you can see if that bishop is looking around for danger, the king is never going to be able to catch him. All right, we've got 4 of the 6 pieces learned, but before we can move on, I want you to answer some questions about the king.